Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm filming a tag video. This one's actually a really cool one. I mean, they're all really cool. But I saw Map Beauty here on YouTube, or Monica. I actually am subscribed to her channel. And she does a lot of fun content. She does a Will I Buy It series. I think she does it every Wednesday. I can't quite remember, but I really enjoy watching that, and she created her own tag video, and this one is called the Part-Time YouTuber Tag, which I thought is very aptly titled for many people here on YouTube. So I'm gonna tag all of you in case you are a YouTube creator. Feel free to do this. I'm sure it'll make her day, and it's actually a really fun one, especially for nosy people like me that want to know more about their favorite YouTubers. I think this is a super fun one. So thank you, Monica, for making this awesome tag video. And without further blabbering, let's get into it. So her first question is, what is your main gig? Do you work full-time? Are you a student, a parent? Spill the beans. So I'm not a parent, I'm not a student. I was for a very, very long time when my channel first started, but I haven't been in school for quite some years now. I do work full-time. Without being like overly specific, I work for my father-in-law. He is an entrepreneur and he has a few businesses that he owns. So me and my husband actually both work for him, and we work together and we have a lot of fun doing that. So yeah, that's my full-time gig. I definitely consider YouTube like my fun side hustle, but I'm sure that's one of the questions coming up. So yeah, that's what I do. Number two, what made you want to start YouTube? Originally, I created my channel when I was very young. Well, I mean, compared to now. And I definitely wanted to be a blogger. I kind of started a YouTube channel as an element to my blog. So I would just film like random little makeup videos and things like that. Nothing too serious. It's definitely snowballed into something much bigger now, but that's initially kind of what got me into YouTube. And I was very curious about how social media worked and how it would affect marketing. I went to school right before social media really blew up, and now there's like people learning in class about Facebook and stuff like that. I didn't have that experience when I was in college, even though I went to school for marketing, and social media is what I really loved. So yeah, I kind of started all of it as like an experiment because I wanted to teach myself blogging and social media and things like that. And that's really what got me started on YouTube as well. Number three, what is your channel about? Do you stick to one niche or do you cover a few? So I would definitely say my niche is makeup compared to like the wide variety of topics people cover on YouTube. It's so funny. My husband says like, if he doesn't know something, he knows that there's a YouTube video out there that's gonna teach him how to do it. So I guess makeup, even though that's so broad, I think in the grand scheme of things, that is a niche. I just love makeup. Like, that's it. I don't know what the rhyme, the reason. Like, sometimes I think people probably think like, that's so sick and disgusting how much makeup she has, but you know what? It's what makes me happy, and damn, you know, I'm not hurting anyone, so that is my niche. Number four, did you always know YouTube would be a side gig, or did you ever want to be a full-time YouTuber? So I always think of it as a side gig. If it ever were to be a full-time job, I wouldn't be mad about it. I think it would be really fun to be a YouTuber full-time. I do love my full-time job because I get to work with my husband, I get to work for my family, and you know, we have a good time at work, but when it's really cold outside, like, I wouldn't be mad if I had to stay in my house and play with makeup. But you know, it's always fun to like think about and fantasize about, but I don't really see myself doing YouTube full time. It would have to be a pretty big figure that I was making on AdSense before I could comfortably just like let go of a full time job. And let me tell you, my AdSense check is nowhere near that amount. So I don't see YouTube becoming a full-time job anytime soon for me. Number five, what is your schedule like? When do you film? When do you edit? So right now my schedule is every day, and I did try to pre-film because I wanted to, you know, make sure I had enough content to get me through December. And the thing is too, like, life is so unpredictable. you know, you can't leave it till the last minute. So with the holidays, like right now, I'm pre-filming this video just so I have a video that I can post one day in December. If I don't end up posting it in December, I'll post it in January, etc., etc. My regular YouTube schedule is every other day, every even day of the month. So I post on the 2nd, the 4th, the 6th, you get what I mean. And it is challenging, but it also holds me very accountable what days are coming up. And so then I don't really slack off because I expect to film 15 videos a month. And that's what I do, and most of it I do try to pre-film or batch film if I have an enormous amount of time on the weekends. Sometimes I'll film a quick video after work, or if I get a new palette and, you know, I feel like it's worthwhile filming right away, I'll, you know, do that. But yeah, I hustle, you guys. I definitely prioritize YouTube a lot because it's important to me, and my husband knows how important it is to me, so he definitely is very understanding, and we definitely make it work, and it's just so fun for me, and like I said, it's important to me, so I make sure I get it done. I've stuck to my every other day, I think, for almost a full year now. I may have missed a few here and there, but I'm enormously proud of my YouTube library. I think I'm almost to like 800 videos at this point, and I don't know, I feel like, yeah, you know, some of them aren't amazing videos by any means, but I still feel really good about myself and what I've accomplished on YouTube this past year. Number 6, how do you keep your YouTube channel organized? Do you plan videos ahead of time or just film what you feel like? So I feel like for me, I'm very organized, but then I see other YouTubers and how organized they are, and it makes me look like the most disorganized person. Basically, I am one of those people, I love technology, but not always, so I love having a planner. I use the Simplified Planner by Emily Lay. If you guys want to check it out, I do have a discount link in my description box, and no, I'm not trying to pimp you out another planner, but I genuinely love my planner. This is my first time using it, and I've used it for a full year now, and I already got my 2020 planner. I'm so excited. So basically, I have a month at a glance in my planner, and that's where I put all my YouTube plans, and it's strictly reserved for YouTube, so I plan all my videos for the month by using each square to put the video that is scheduled for that day, and then either I will film it, or on the weekends I'll film, and then I'll kind of schedule them in and kind of mix and match so I don't have like 3 iLooks in a row or 3 Will I Bites in a row. I try to like mix and match my videos so that you guys don't get too bored, but that's kind of how I stay organized. Number 7, how do you feel about sponsored videos on YouTube? Would you ever do one on your channel? I think that's a really interesting question because I was definitely one of those people when I was a smaller YouTube channel. I definitely didn't understand sponsorships. I thought sponsorships were horseshit. I hated that. You know, it felt like a lot of YouTubers were selling out and things like that. But now as my channel has grown and the makeup industry is getting so, I mean, it's crazy. The makeup releases, like who can keep up? And realistically, nobody wants to spend their whole paycheck on product, you know? So I've definitely kind of realized the value of sponsorships. And I do think that it's really cool that smaller YouTubers can make a full time living doing something like this, and a big way for that is sponsorships. So I don't really see a problem with people doing sponsorship videos as long as they are being honest and they are also letting their audience know that it's a sponsored video. I don't have a problem with it, but it's definitely something I've changed my mind on since first starting out on YouTube. And I think that if you feel negatively about sponsorship videos, just don't watch the video, or, you know, just try and understand where creators are coming from, because essentially YouTube is free entertainment, and like most of us are doing this out of sheer passion. And like me, I don't make a check out of YouTube. Like I do, but it's maybe like $100 a month, which if you guys watch my haul video, like my monthly haul video, you know that that's not paying any of my bills. So hopefully, you know, you guys can be more open to it. And to me, it doesn't bother me at all. I don't know why I just got on my soapbox like I need to convince you guys that sponsorships are okay. It's just me and giving you my opinion. So I hope you respect that. And the last question, what do you think is the biggest challenge for doing YouTube part-time? That's a good one. So I would definitely say funding for me is a big one, just because I do put a lot of money into my channel and I don't feel like I get anything back as far as monetary gain. But of course, just like the conversations I get to have, the people I've gotten to meet, like, it's been wonderful. Sometimes I talk to my friends in real life and I'm like, wow, these people must think I'm really boring because I don't have anything really to talk about other than makeup. So I can have like a whole conversation about makeup over hours in my Instagram DMs, but if I'm sitting in front of somebody in real life, it's like, I'm just like, what should I ask them about next? What, you know, it's like, you can't talk to people about YouTube drama, like, so silly, right? But yeah, I think the challenge for me is definitely financial, only because at some point I can't keep spending as much as I spend on makeup right now, and that's okay. I'm okay with it. I need to, you know, make good decisions for myself, so I am gonna try and buy less makeup in 2020. Oh my gosh, I'm gonna turn over a new leaf, guys. Just wait and see. I just wanna be more thoughtful. I bought a lot of crap in 2019. I bought a lot of crap in 2018. I still have a lot of crap that I bought in the last 2 years that I haven't even shown on my channel. So I think my biggest goal for 2020 is making better decisions, buying things that I think will get good views on my channel, and decluttering. I'm gonna declutter the crap out of my collection. I'm gonna keep what I want, get rid of what I don't want, not hold on to things for the sake of holding on to them, and live my best fucking life. Anyway, guys, that is everything for the part-time YouTuber tag video. I'm gonna go ahead and link Monica's video down in my description box. And like I said, if you are a creator, definitely do this tag. I think it's a fun one. And I really, really hope you guys enjoyed. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you in the next one. Bye, guys. Bye.